the labrum in the hip is a rubbery gasket that lines the border of the socket here. And the function of the labrum is to surround the ball in the socket and act as a suction cup seal for the ball, stabilizing it inside of the socket. Over time, in some people whose ball isn't quite round enough, the edge of the ball can impact the corner of the socket, causing the labrum to peel back up off of the edge of the socket, resulting in a labral tear. A tear of the labrum can present with multiple types of symptoms, but most commonly the tear presents with pain in the front of the hip, in the groin area, and the pain can be worsened with activities that involve repetitive hip flexion, which is bending the hip up, as well as for sitting for long periods of time, squatting and going up and down the stairs, as well as being engaged in an athletic activity. Treatment options for a tear of the acetabular labrum first begin with physical therapy to work on strengthening of the hip and the core musculature to optimize the function of the hip. If this is unsuccessful in a certain subset of our patients, we can consider injections, which are targeted to relieve pain and inflammation in the hip. And if all of those measures are unsuccessful, depending on the orientation of the ball in the socket, we can consider an arthroscopic surgery, which is minimally invasive, to address the labral tear. A hip arthroscopy is a procedure that we do minimally invasively through three small portals using a camera and some small instruments within the hip. We're able to go inside of the hip and take a look at the labrum, which is typically torn, and we're able to put sutures around the labrum to reattach it back to the socket. And then we go to the ball side and we're able to shave the ball to make the ball a rounder shape to prevent it from damaging the labrum in the future. If you're having an issue with either the shoulder, knee, or the hip, I'm happy to see you in the Kona, Spartanburg, or Duncan locations. We'll get some imaging studies and get your affected body part checked out and figure out exactly what's going on.